MLB The Show is your home for postseason baseball. It's Game 4 of the American League Division Series between the Houston Astros and the Minnesota Twins. Hi again, everyone. Matt Vaskirjian. Welcome to our special postseason coverage of Baseball on the Show. With me is Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac. And Dan, lots of storylines here as we approach the start of Game 4.
Well, because this is a five-game series, this is an elimination game. I think that any time a team's season is on the line, they have to play like it. I think they'll be really aggressive and try to force the other team into some mistakes. If they play well, all of a sudden this series is all tied up and we'll have a Game 5 to look forward to.
Set for what should be a good one. Lineups and first pitch are next. Michael Pineda is on the mound and he'll look to wrap up this division series. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
When Michael Pineda's right, he's one of the top pitchers in the game of baseball. He's another guy. He throws from that high three-quarter arm delivery, gets good sinking action. The ball will tail down and away from lefties and down and into righties. And you'll know early on if he's throwing the ball well. You see some early swings and misses.
And now in the box, Jose Altuve. And we are set for baseball here this evening. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch.
Nope, at the ball.
Weather not much of an issue tonight. A mild 65 degrees here at game time. And nope. He lays off. Ball four. And the leadoff man is on to begin the ball game.
That is not the way he wanted to start off this half inning. It's one thing to walk the leadoff hitter, but it's even more painful when the leadoff hitter is an absolute burner and he can really wreak some havoc on the bases.
Next, it'll be Alex Bregman. And there's ball two now.
Boy, not exactly what you'd like as a pitcher. One of the keys is to minimize your pitches, attack the strike zone early, a lot of deep counts, and working himself into a lot of trouble.
The 2-1. Hit high and deep to right center. Long run for the center fielder. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning.
That is Bird. The left fielder, number 23, Michael Brantley.
Here's Michael Brantley, head-to-head against Michael Pineda. He's just 1-for-6. Runner at first here, one man out. And they pitch out here, but nothing's happening. Ball two. Set and the 2-1 pitch. Ground ball to second. This could be two. Simmons relay to first in time, and just like that, this side is retired. Pretty painless half of the inning all told. And now the Twins will go to work on offense. We've got no score. Jose Urquidy will do his best on the mound to keep his team alive here in the division series. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, it's hard to have all four of your pitches on, but I think if this guy can have two or three of his four pitches and have command of them, he's going to have a really good game.
Max Kepler, the next to grab a bat. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. 2-2. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Brantley is under it. Looks it into his glove, and there's one gone.
Batting second, the second baseman, Luis.
Now one down with the bases empty, and next to hit will be Luis Arraez. One out, nobody on. down the left field line. Legs turning. He's headed for second. And he is in at second base with a one-out double.
Wow, he almost blew that fastball by him, but he shows some quick hands to catch up to it and drive it down the opposite line. Didn't keep it fair by much, but he did, and that's a nice two-bagger.
Standing in now, Josh Donaldson. And here's a pitch swung on and missed, one and two now.
Hey, I love that pitch right there. Better execution after just giving up an extra base hit.
And he fouls this one off. Able to protect the plate with two strikes, and he'll see another one.
After that slider away, he must have set his sights out there because he took that fastball in like he had no chance.
Another one sent foul. Another 1-2 delivery. And a swing and a miss as they got him with the slider there, two away. And with two away now, let's have a look at our playoff tree. And as you can see, the winner of this series faces a stern test ahead with the evil empire, the New York Yankees, waiting for the winner in the ALCS. Now it would be the Minnesota DH. Nelson Cruz, opportunity for him here to pick up that runner from second with two away. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. And a fastball swung on and missed, and the side is retired. Back-to-back strikeouts keep him out of danger. Back with more of Game 4 on the show after this. So here's the Astros cleanup hitter, Carlos Correa. He'll get us started in the top of the second. Lifted in the air toward the line and right. Kepler's there for it. One away. Next will be the designated hitter, Yordan Alvarez. No score here as we play inning number two. Still even at 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. Shot down the line. It's a fair ball. He's through first and hustling for second. And he'll pull into second with one away.
As we take another look here, you can see it's a two-seam fastball running away from him at the plate. So he does this smart thing, not trying to pull it or just rolling over it, just goes with it and has enough juice on it to drive it for a double.
Into the box, Yuli Gurriel. Strike two called, and it's even at two. Chopped at third. Donaldson's got to get rid of it, and there are two away now. Next to stand in is Kyle Tucker, runner in scoring position with two gone. Two out here and a runner at second. One and two as he chases the slider.
Swing and a miss on a nasty slider right there. Always felt toughest pitch in the game. If you're a guy who liked to work the big part of the field, you were on that fastball middle away. That slider looked like a heater for about 56 feet, 6 inches.
Look out. That one almost got away from him. 2-2 now.
Man, this guy's a grinder. Fouls off good pitches and doesn't seem to swing at the ones just off the corner. This guy's a pitcher's nightmare.
The 2-2. Strike three called, and the inning is over. Astros lead one. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and set to go is the veteran first baseman, Miguel Sano. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Call didn't go his way on 2-1, but it's important here on 3-1 to still make a quality pitch. You have to have the mindset that you're still the one in the driver's seat.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. Fouled off. Now the 3-2 pitch. A fly ball well hit. Ranging back is Tucker. On the warning track, he makes the catch.
Batting fifth, the left fielder, Kyle Garlick.
Next, it'll be Kyle Garlick. Bottom of the second here with no score. Here's a swing and a little tapper in front of the mound. And there's out number two. Two down, no one on base. And that'll bring up the speedy outfielder, Byron Buxton. Now the 3-2 pitch. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Down go the Twins in order. We'll move to the third with no score. Set to begin the third inning in this one. Had him off stride that time, and it's 1-2.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
Here's another 1-2. Hard hit ball to second, but an Adam ball right to him for the first down. Now to the plate, Jason Castro. Now a swing and a miss here as he's down on strikes. So it's two up, two down to begin the third.
Boy, there's nothing better from a pitcher standpoint than watching that high fastball, a high piece of cheese swung at and missed. That pitch looks so inviting to hit, but it's awfully tough to put in play.
Stepping in now, Jose Altuve. Line towards center field. And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit. Two out hit. That'll bring Alex Bregman to the plate as well.
The third baseman, number two, Alex Bregman.
And that'll bring up the former first rounder, Alex Bregman. He gets a shot to hit here in the inning following the two out single.
Yeah, that hit might not amount to much, but anytime you could extend an inning and give a guy with plenty of pop a chance to swing it, the outlook of an inning changes dramatically.
Third inning, no score to this point. And here's a slider for a called strike, and he's behind 1-2 now. hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Good plate discipline to lay off the slider that time, and he draws even a 2-2. And he tries to get him to reach for it, but it stays outside. 3-2.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Swing, and he takes this the other way to right. Kepler gets under it and makes the catch to end the inning. One left for Houston. Home half of the third coming up. No score. Bottom of the third now, and now it'll be the catcher, Ryan Jeffers. Goes the other way and sends it deep down the right field line. And he's going to have room to put this one away, and that's the first out.
Got it, no.
So now to the plate will be Andrelton Simmons. The 1-1. Now a swing as he rifles this one into center for a base hit.
Now batting, right fielder, Matt Kepler.
Into the box now, Max Kepler. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball.
Hey, he threw that pitch with a purpose to get a double play. Good job to let it go by, though, as a hitter.
Off-speed pitch misses here, and he runs it to 3-1.
No reason to sit on anything other than hard stuff in a location you like and drive it right now.
The 3-1. Swing and a miss, and that'll fill the count at 3-2. Oh, and this is swung on and missed. Four strikeouts already, and that's out number two. So a runner at first with two away, and next to him will be Luis Arraez. Set, here's the 3-1. Swing and a liner. Well, this will find the shortstop's glove for the third out of the inning. One left for Minnesota. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless. And here's the left-handed hitting Michael Brantley as we begin the top of the fourth.
The old adage, pitching and defense have been stellar so far. They've certainly kept both offenses in check.
This is hit high in the air out toward left center. And he will run this one down, moving to his right, and that's the first out of the inning. One out, base is empty. And the former number one overall pick in American League Rookie of the Year, Carlos Correa, bats next. 1-1. Looked at for ball number two. Still all zeros in the run column here in the fourth inning. Dan, does this continue or does somebody score here?
Oh, you have to love. You know, Matt, we have so many of these games that are 12 to 10 and 9 to 8. It's nice to see a low scoring pitcher's duel for once.
Fastball is looked at for strike two. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at bat will continue. Got to third, and there are two away.
The batter, number 44, designated hitter.
The plate now is the designated hitter, Yordan Alvarez. He doubled his last time up. Both teams with just two hits apiece thus far. And it's fouled away.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Pineda sets his sights. 2-2 on its way home. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one.
Looked like he was cheating a heater right there. A little bit too far out in front. Got to fight.
A swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. 1-2-3 go the Astros. On to the bottom of the fourth now, still with no score. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And set to go is the third baseman, Josh Donaldson. And that misses for ball four. It's a leadoff walk that starts the bottom of the fourth.
Well, they haven't been able to scratch a run across yet, so maybe this walk will jumpstart their offense a little bit.
Here's Nelson Cruz now. Comes into this at-bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. One and two now as that one's fouled off. And here's a slider. Strike three called, and that'll be the first out of the inning. Here's Miguel Sano. Flied out in his first at bat, so make him 0-for-1 so far.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
The left fielder,
ready now is Kyle Garlick. He's 0-for-1 thus far. And there's a fastball well off the plate inside. And he comes back with a gorgeous slider there for strike two.
Hey, I'd like to see a little bit more discipline in that. You get a count in your favor and swinging a pitch that bad? Not good.
Here now the 2-2. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side. In there, a base hit. And that runner will hold up at second with two aboard now.
Well, that's what's so disappointing as a pitcher, D-Lo. You make a really good pitch, and yet this guy's so big and so strong, he's able to muscle it into right field for a base hit.
Yeah, you hand your batting gloves to the first base coach right there, and you thank your lucky stars. That's a nice AB.
In now, Byron Buxton. And that one misses badly. It's ball two. And two strikes to the Twins center fielder.
For the guy in the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
He spoils another one, and we'll do it again. No runs, three hits, and no errors in the ballgame for Minnesota. Softly on a line to third. But little trouble handling this one down there at third as that will end the inning. Twin strand a pair through four. Still tied, nothing, nothing. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Thanks, Matt. During the commercial break, I discussed the Astros offense with Houston's manager, and he told me he's pretty unhappy with their discipline at the plate in this one. He said their pitch selection has been the main reason for their struggles today, as far too often they've been swinging at pitches outside the strike zone. That's leading to a lot of soft contact and easy outs. So the focus going forward is on shrinking the zone and forcing the opposing pitching to throw more strikes.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. close as you 2-1 now.
That was a tempting pitch to swing at right there. A big power guy like this really wants something that he can elevate and drive out of the ballpark.
And this will be pulled in just in front of the warning track for the first out. No one on with one down. And in to hit next will be the outfielder Kyle Tucker. No runs, two hits, no errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. Two balls and a strike. Lifted the other way down the left field line. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. Trying to send him packing for the second time. He takes strike three called on the fastball. Couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away. Pretty clear he didn't like the call there on the outside part of the plate, but probably too good to take. And he's down on strikes for the second time.
Yeah, that pitch was right on the black. Beautiful pitch. And even if we had robot umps, he'd still be out. But the only difference would be he wouldn't be able to compete.
Plate now, Miles Straw. Hit hard on the ground at first. Fielded cleanly, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Astros go down 1-2-3. Halfway home, still no score. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. In between innings, I was able to catch up with the manager of the Twins to discuss his thoughts on Minnesota's lineup so far. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. Despite the fact that they've yet to push a run across, the game is still tied, and the pitch count for their opposition is really getting up there. They think that making him work as hard as he has is going to pay off later in the game, and that they just need to stick to the process.
Now, thank you, Heidi. Ryan Stanek. 6'4" right-hander comes in out of the bullpen to do the pitching. Now at the plate, here is Ryan Jeffers. Flew out in his only at-bat so far. Set and the 1-1 pitch. Count moves to a ball and two strikes now. The 1-2.
Two balls, two strikes.
And he wasn't going to hit that one with an or. The strikeout, and there's one gone.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
Standing in now, Andrelton Simmons. And he fouls. He pops it up. Gurriel has room in foul territory. Two gone. Now back to the leadoff spot in the Twins lineup. Stepping in, Max Kepler. His career numbers against this pitcher. He's 0 for 5. Bullet back up the middle. He's under it, and that ends the inning. Twins are set down 1-2-3. Sixth inning coming up. Still zip, zip. Jason Castro, the catcher, is in. Struck out in his first at-bat. The 2-1. Eight. count now, 3-2.
Hey, there's not a lot you can do with a slider breaking down and in unless you catch it way out front. I like the idea of taking it and making the pitcher bring you something a little more hittable.
And a fast swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight.
This guy is really locked in on the bump right now. He's just playing good old-fashioned hardball right now, just rearing back and letting it go. And it seems like this lineup, they don't have an answer for anything he's bringing so far.
Into the box, Jose Altuve. Misses, ball two. Bases are empty, one man out. Fouled off. The 2-2 one more time. It's laid off and the count runs full.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
And now pitch on the way. Bounce it to the left side. And that's the second out. And that'll bring up Alex Bregman. And then it seems like this starter is just dominating the game right now. Feels like we're seeing a lot of three up, three down innings.
No doubt about that, Nat. Hey, I've enjoyed watching him go about his business, but I'm also interested to see if this offense can figure out a way to get a couple of cracks in his armor before it gets too late.
Yeah, that remains to be seen. Bases are empty here with two men out. A ball and two strikes. Off the end of the bat, foul, and he might have been fortunate to stay alive that time.
This could be a huge win for the guy on the mound if he's able to get out of this inning 1-2-3 and start fresh next inning with the middle of the order.
Pineda's ready. Here comes the pitch. Little too much bite on the slider that time, taken outside. Frozen on the fastball. Never chance, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Astros. Still no score. Bottom of the sixth inning now, and next to hit will be Luis Arraez. Now the 3-2 pitch, lifted down the line in left. Bregman trying to get there, and that will end up a foul ball. Count still full, 3-2. Neither guy giving in. Here's the next one. Pulled toward right center field. Strong is there, and he has it for the first out. Leadoff man gone, and then bring in the third baseman, Josh Donaldson. A 1-1. High pop-up. And he'll squeeze this one for the second out. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter. Nelson Cruz, lifetime in this matchup. He's 1-for-2. One and one, here it is.
Count 1-2.
He struck him out, the third time he's fanned in the game. Down go the Twins in order, and this is still a nothing-nothing ball game. Striding in for Houston, Michael Brantley. Third trip to the plate for him here tonight. 0-for-2 at this point. swing and a ball hard hit toward deep right. Kepler is there and he makes the catch for the out.
I know they say sometimes that these things even out, but that was a bullet line drive that gets caught. He would have represented the go-ahead run.
At the plate, Carlos Correa. Ground ball sent back up the middle. And that'll get on through into center, and he's got himself a one-out hit.
Hey, D-Ro, that's a one-out single right there. Hey, the pitcher hasn't pitched out of the stretch in a while. He's been pretty sharp so far in this one.
Yeah, and hopefully that runner right there can get his attention a little bit more diverted on first base, and then he leaves a cookie over the middle of the plate.
Here's the Minnesota skipper making his way out to the mound. And we're going to see a pitching change, as that's going to do it for his starter here tonight. He'll depart with our score tied, and he'll still be accountable for the runner at first. The best he can do is a no decision on this one. Hansel Robles comes on to pitch here with one man gone in the top of the seventh. Stepping in now, Yordan Alvarez. To right field and deep. Look at this thing go. Gone! A two-run shot that gives the lead. A two-run blast to straightaway right field. His third home run of this series. And the Astros have taken a 2-0 lead.
What a great feeling right there as he circles the pillows, finally able to get this offense potentially going with one swing of the bat, being shut out all game, but not anymore.
In now, Yuli Gurriel. And it's fouled away. Hard on the ground towards short. Simmons has it. And there are two away now. Next up for the Astros, Kyle Tucker, 0 for 2 from him so far in this one. Grounded back up the middle. And that's through for a hit.
There's a hard hit ground ball. Pitcher not able to get a glove on it. Hard single up the middle.
Yeah, watch your lips right there, Dad. Sent it back right where it came from.
To the plate now, Miles Straw. High in the air out to center field. Buxton able to track it down for the third out. Astros plate two on the two-run home run. Get up and stretch. Home half of the seventh coming up. It's now 2-0 Houston. Joe Smith will take over on the mound to start the bottom of the seventh.
Number 38, Joe Smith.
So the big bat of Miguel Sano digs in next. He's 0 for 2 thus far in this one. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now. Payoff pitch home. And that misses ball four. It's a leadoff walk to start the home seventh.
Man, that's a tough one to swallow. You're hanging on to a slim lead, and the last thing you want to do is give up a leadoff walk. Seems like those are the ones that always come back to haunt you, so we'll see if that's the case here.
The next twin up, Kyle Garlic. He's one for two in this one. Now the 1-1 pitch.
You can definitely tell with that foul off right there that he's picking up spin on this pitcher's off-speed stuff. Maybe expect a fastball on this next one.
Oh. Off the plate that time and a little high. It's even at 2-2. Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first down.
That was some nice execution on that pitch. Spotted it nicely down around the bottom of the zone. And when you do that, especially with two strikes, not a lot of guys are going to hurt you. You're going to get a lot of ground balls and swings and misses down there.
So now to the plate, Byron Buxton. And he gets the corner with that one, 2-2.
That's three straight sliders in a row. I'd be shocked. I would be shocked if he went to that well a fourth time. I'd be looking here.
Lifted out towards straightaway center field. Strong is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. Pedro Baez takes over pitching duties, looking to get that final out now here in this seventh inning. Ryan Jeffers will be the first to greet him here as he stands in with a runner at first and two away. Two out with the man at first. Good take there to lay off the high fastball. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Swing and a miss at a slider for a strike.
Look at the radar gun on that slider. Off speed pitch, 91 miles an hour. That's just pure filth.
Had to wait back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact. Payoff pitch one more time. High in the air into shallow left center. Correa ranging into the outfield. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. Twins wind up stranding one. They trail things here 2-0. Cody Stashek has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 64, Cody Stashek.
Ready to begin the eighth, and next to hit is the catcher, Jason Castro. The 1-1 is swung on and missed for strike number two. Some movement now in the Minnesota bullpen as a right-hander's up and throwing. Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball. And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one. What's your take on all the strikeouts we see in the game today, Dan? That was his third tonight, and it seems we're seeing that a lot more these days.
Yeah, Matt, there's been a real change in philosophy as far as hitting in baseball today. A lot of guys think now that an out is an out, a strikeout is just as good as a regular out, but we're seeing strikeouts at an alarming rate in baseball right now.
Into the box now, Jose Altuve. Fouled away. And it's another K. So back-to-back strikeout victory. start this relief outing.
No problems for him on the mound since he's come out of the pen to start this inning. That's back-to-back K's, and he's making it look pretty easy. This has the makings of a good outing so far.
At the plate, Alex Bregman.
And
it's up to a 3-2 full count now.
Hey, there was great arm action on that 3-1 changeup right here. He's got this guy thinking. That's the beauty right now.
Well, the first baseman is under it to make the play, and that retires the side. So they're held in check here this half of the inning. Not too many more shots left. Home half of the eighth coming up. The Astros lead it 2-0. Bottom of inning number 8 set to go. And stepping in is the veteran shortstop, Andrelton Simmons. Here's the 2-1.
Whoa, that's it down.
Yeah, well, down 2. You better believe they'd gladly take a leadoff walk right here. Anything to get a base runner on and get that tying run to the plate.
A 3-1 pitch. Line hard into left. He lays out for it, but he can't pull it in. Around second now, and they still haven't flagged this one down. And the Twins have a golden opportunity here. They've got themselves a leadoff triple.
Every coach will tell you when you're down by 2, you don't want to take too many chances on the base pass. Regardless, he hustles into third for the triple, and the tying run is coming to the plate.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention.
So with a left-handed hitter waiting, they'll go to their own left-hander out of the bullpen.
Number 62, Blake.
Stepping in now, Max Kepler. Swing, line, drive. That's going to be trouble. And they are on the board as the run scores from third to cut the lead to 2-1 now. And he's going to get to second now with nobody out. So much of this game is situational hitting, guys. Nice job there.
Yeah, you've got to find a way to pick your teammates up when you're given the chance. And he doesn't try to do too much right here. He just takes what's there. Safely on second, and his buddy is high-fiving teammates in the dugout.
Into the box, Luis Arraez. Hit hard on the ground at short, right to him.
He's
and that's out number one. Here's the third baseman, Josh Donaldson. The base knocked to the outfield could score the tying run from second. Pretty badly there as he reaches to poke this one foul. Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away. Cannoli Paredes takes the mound now, and it appears he's being brought in to face the right-handed batter who waits next.
Yeah, you usually don't hear the term righty specialist very often, but that's kind of how they're using it here, Matt. Most hitters have a harder time against pitchers of the same handedness, so we'll see if this move pans out.
Bring up the big stick of Nelson Cruz. Not much in the way of productivity from him so far, but he's got a chance to come through here in a crucial spot.
Yeah, it's time now that he has to put the rest of those bats behind him because none of that matters if he can clutch up when it really counts.
Here's the 1-1. And they'll go off speed here as this pitch misses. It's 2-1.
Sitting in a good spot right here. 2-1 count is yet to see a fastball. Have to be sitting on one right here.
Runner in scoring position at second with two down. Down the first baseline. The 2-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
On, he jumps on this one. It's high and deep to center. A ball that's carrying. He's got it as the tying run is left on base. But a run will score in the inning on this RBI double. On to the ninth now for Memorial Park. It's the Astros 2 and the Twins 1. Tyler Duffy enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. Set for the start of the inning. And coming forward, the veteran outfielder, Michael Brantley. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Ground ball, left side. Oh, look at Donaldson. He is out. And what a vital play there, preventing the leadoff man from getting aboard. Blake now, Carlos Correa. And this ball runs away for ball two, 2-1.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch. But if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
Into the windup. Here's the 2-1 pitch. Back up the middle. And that'll find its way into center field for a one-out hit.
Hey, guys, he's not known for being a singles hitter right here, but that's his second knock of the game.
And I'm sure he'll take him, but the guys on the other side of the scorecard might be thinking we really avoided a worse fate. Yordan Alvarez will stand in again, and we'll take you back to the seventh inning. This was a two-run home run, and it was one of the key blows in the ballgame thus far. Swing and a little tapper. Again, a 1-2. That's lifted the other way out to left.
Garland
is right there as he'll put it away without much problem for the second out. Stepping up is Yuli Gurriel. He bounced out last time up.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got burner wheels down the first baseline. I don't think he even concerns himself with that. He has to put it on the ground. That's part of what makes him successful.
Gurriel behind the ball and two strikes. Runner on first with two away. Skied into straightaway right. Kepler's there for it. And that retires the side. Astros leave one as they're unable to add to their 2-1 lead. Ryan Pressly comes out of the bullpen to shut things down here in the ninth.
Number 55, Ryan Pressly.
Now it'll be Miguel Sano. It was a walk in his last trip. Swung on and missed. One and two now.
Yeah, guys, he's got so much respect for this guy's fastball. You could tell he was out in front on that slider. I think he goes to the well one more time with that pitch.
And he wasn't going to hit that one with an or. The strikeout, and there's one gone.
When your closer comes in and strikes out the first guy he faces, everyone on the team can kind of take a deep breath. Still have two more outs to get, but retiring that leadoff guy is always huge when you're trying to shut a game down.
One out, nobody on. A great pitch there as he couldn't get extended on that one, and he's down on strikes for the second out.
Well, you have to feel pretty confident about the way this one's going to end up as a manager. Two hitters, two strikeouts from the closer. There's not a whole lot more he can do to instill confidence that he's going to wrap this thing up without any problem.
Jorge Polanco will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run.
Number 11.
Set and the 2-1 pitch. Now a swing and a ground ball. This should do it. Throw to first will be in time to get him. And the Astros have battled back to knock this series up at 2 games apiece as this ball game is over.
Hey, which is normally the case in these close ones. You have a one-run game, a 2-1 decision. Really good pitching and defense in this one, and a lot of really good execution made this a fun game to watch.
This one, definitely a low-scoring affair as we get one last look at our final line score. Close one tonight, 2-1 the final score. The Houston Astros have evened up the series at 2 wins apiece. Ryan Stanek pitches well enough to get the W. Michael Pineda is settled with a loss after giving up only one earned. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter, at MLB The Show.
Fans, our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Astros, 2 runs, 6 hits, no errors. They left 5 men on base. For the Twins, 1 run, 5 hits, no errors. They left 6 men on base. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 37 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this evening. We remind you to please drive home safely.